Naturally. Once you've initialized a dictionary, you're going to want to add items to it. To add a key-value pair to a dictionary, set the value for the key using subscript syntax. So here we'll add a couple entries to our animal groups dictionary. A group of crows is called a murder. I always thought that was a strange one. And a group of monkeys is called a troop. If we use the count method, which has the same syntax as the array class's count method, we can see that before we had 3 entries, but now we have 5. And if we print out the dictionary, we can see the 2 new entries. Removing a value from a dictionary looks very similar to adding a value, but in this case, the value for the key is assigned to nil. And after we assign the value for crows to nil, we can see that the crows murder pair has been removed from the dictionary. What if we want to change the value associated with a key? For this, we have a couple options. We can keep using the same versatile subscript syntax, like this. Here, let's change troop to barrel. Or we could use the method updateValueForKey. This method is interesting because it returns an optional value. This is good, because if you try to update a value that's not in your dictionary, your program won't crash. The updateValue method will just return nil and go ahead and add the new key-value pair to the dictionary. And here you can see we've added a crash of rhinosaurs to our dictionary. No pun intended, I swear. If the dictionary does indeed contain the value you tried to update, the updateValueForKey method returns the former value, the old value, like we saw here when the method returned flock. If you want to retrieve the value for a particular key, you can use, you guessed it, subscript syntax. In other words, the dictionary name followed by the key in square brackets. Let's scroll this up and make a little more room. One has to be careful when retrieving values from dictionaries, because retrieving a value for a given key from a dictionary returns an optional. Why would a dictionary return an optional? I'm just going to pause for a few seconds and let you think. It returns an optional because there's always a chance that the key-value pair you're looking for isn't in the dictionary. There are many cases in which a program might ask for a value from a dictionary, not knowing whether it will be there or not. So, it returns an optional, and naturally, that optional needs to be unwrapped. We unwrap a value returned from a dictionary using if-let, just like we'd unwrap any other optional. In this example, we want to retrieve the value for a group of whales, and use that value in this print statement. So we unwrap it like so, and here the optional has a value, pod. So what happens if the key isn't found? No problem, we're covered. Like in this example, Sasquatches are not in our dictionary, so the optional has a nil value. But that's okay, because we've specified exactly what we want the program to do in case of a nil value.